the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, all. We are in the first week of Lent. We continue our journey. Keep listening to the Word of God for instructions and praying for the grace to sustain our decisions in Lenten observances, because we need grace and not just making the decision. So we continue to pray and worship God. I confess to Almighty God, to my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Look kindly, Lord, we pray, on the devotion of your people, that those who by self-denial are restrained in body may by the fruit of good works be renewed in mind. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. The reading from the book of the prophet Jonah. The word of the Lord came to Jonah a second time. Set out for the great city of Nineveh and announce to it the message that I will tell you. So Jonah made ready and went to Nineveh according to the Lord's bidding. Now Nineveh was an enormously large city. It took 3 days to go through it. Jonah began his journey through the city and had gone but a single day's walk, announcing, 40 days more and Nineveh will be destroyed. When the people of Nineveh believed God, they proclaimed the fast, and all of them, great and small, put on sackcloth. When the news reached the king of Nineveh, he rose from his throne, laid aside his robe, and covered himself with sackcloth and sat in the ashes. Then he had this proclaimed throughout Nineveh by decree of the king and his nobles. Neither man nor beast, neither cattle nor sheep shall taste anything. They shall not eat, nor shall they drink water. Man and beast shall be covered with sackcloth and call loudly to God. Every man shall turn from his evil way and from the violence he has in hand. Who knows, God may relent and forgive and withhold his blazing wrath so that we shall not perish. When God saw by their actions how they turned from their evil way, he repented of the evil that he had threatened to do to them, and he did not carry it out. The word of the Lord. A contrite heart and humbled, O God, you will not spurn. A heart contrite and humbled, O God, you will not spurn. Have mercy on me, O God, in your goodness. In the greatness of your compassion, wipe out my offense. Truly, wash me from my guilt, and of my sin, cleanse me. A heart contrite and humbled, O God, you will not spurn. A clean heart create for me, O God, and a steadfast spirit renew within me. Cast me out not from your presence, and your Holy Spirit take not from me. A heart contrite and humbled, O God, you will not spurn. For you are not pleased with sacrifices. Should I offer a burnt offering, you would not accept it. My sacrifice, O God, is a contrite spirit. A heart contrite and humbled, O God, you will not spurn. Glory to you, Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ. Even now, says the Lord, return to me with your whole heart, for I am gracious and merciful. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. While still more people gathered in the crowd, Jesus said to them, "This generation is an evil generation. It seeks a sign, but no sign will be given it except the sign of Jonah. Jonah, just as Jonah became a sign to the Ninevites, so will the Son of Man be to this generation. At the judgment, the Queen of the South will rise with the men of this generation, and she will condemn them because she came from the ends of the earth to hear the wisdom of Solomon, and there is something greater than Solomon here. At the judgment, the men of Nineveh will arise with this generation and condemn it, because at the preaching of Jonah they repented, and there is something greater than Jonah here." The Gospel of the Lord. The gospel content, the words of God, the message of our Lord Jesus Christ is timeless. It's not something that should be abandoned or left behind in the history of whatever world or historical context that those words were spoken. It's timeless. It's relevant in the time it was spoken, during the time Jesus was walking about the streets and the territories of Palestine, Israel. It's still relevant in our society today. But people tend to turn their back to it like it's no longer relevant. And that is why we are experiencing what we are experiencing in this time. Because if we could listen to the gospel and take it seriously, we would have to direct our lives. And all these crazy stuff we hear in our society, they may not be there. But then as we human beings, we are always more or less crazy and disobedient. Let me use the word, that kind of expression. Because right from creation, it has just been that way. When you read Genesis chapter 6, the Bible said that God regretted even ever creating man. Because let me not say that what God saw, he did not anticipate it. That would be like making some statement that are theologically wrong. But then, according to the Bible, the heart of man was like a manufacturing plant for evil. Was like an industry, was like a place that was churning evil in different forms and sizes and different versions, and today has not stopped. So let us be careful, because what Jesus is doing is to warn us, really warn us, because we have a better chance, because the Ninevites never had the word of Jesus, never had God speaking to them directly. What they had was Jonah speaking to them. Thus says the Lord. The queen of the south, Queen Sheba, he came to Solomon. He was hearing the wisdom of God through Solomon. That was a mediator, sort of. So she would be like, okay, this is the words of Solomon and all that. But now it's not like we are hearing it from a prophet or through any other mediator. We are hearing it from God. So why can't we take it seriously? But then, man or humans being who they are, sometimes we don't take these words seriously. So these people who never heard the words of God directly, will they stand up on the last day to condemn us? Like tell us, if we had the opportunity you had, we would have utilized it and do something with it. That is what Jesus is telling us. Let us not live our lives in a manner that these words we hear will stand up and condemn us instead of liberating us. Let us not live our lives in the manner that at the end of our sojourn here on earth, these words will stand and say, you had me, 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 and you never did something with me. This is what Lent is all about. Trying to do some kind of stock picking. How is the journey going? Are we doing well? With the words of God and the commandment of God and the directives and the divine precepts we have been hearing, what are we doing with them? Because these are still the words of Jesus. As he was going about in the streets of Galilee, in the streets of Palestine, in the streets of Israel, saying this or saying that, teaching this or teaching that, he is still teaching us because he says, I will be with you till the end of time. He is still in our midst. He is still teaching us. As much as we may not be seeing him physical, he is spirit. So how seriously are we taking his words? Or are we allowing our human rationality and our human reasonability inputs to direct us more than the word of God? So sometimes we may rationalize over our failings, we may rationalize over our sinfulness, we may rationalize over the ways we are living our lives that are not aligning with the words of God and the commandment. And we may rationalize about it and say, oh, this is how I want to live my life. It's not really all about how you want to live your life. It's all about, is that how God wants you to live your life? Because whether you like it or not, we don't own ourselves in total. We don't know the mystery in life. We don't know the mystery in death. We don't know the mystery of living and growing old. We don't know. No matter the kind of study we put into it, we may not really have the whole details in our hands. Someone has it, and that person keeps directing us. So during this Lent, let us get back into the recesses of our minds, sit down, and count our blessings and count our losses and make amends. Like the Ninevites today did, when the words of Jonah came to them, they went back. They said, no, we can't be living this way. Let us change. Yes, in as much as the emphasis today is not about perishing, the emphasis today is not all about the judgment of God, the emphasis today is not all about God destroying us. No, the emphasis is on the mercy and the love of God. But for you to enjoy that mercy and the love of God, you need to open yourself up to that mercy, to that love. It's not about God destroying us, no. That is not what Jesus came to tell us. He came to tell us about the mercy of God. He came to tell us about the love of God. But then, that calls for a response. And that response is, you have to open yourself up for that mercy. You have to open yourself up for that love. If you don't, it means you are removing yourself from the gift God has given. So we continue to pray in this Lent as we journey with Jesus, that he may help us to understand and accept his words and allow the mercy of God and the love of God nourish our lives and make them better. May Jesus continue to help us. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, you become our spiritual food. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. We offer you, Lord, what you have given to be dedicated to your name, that just as for our benefit you make these gifts a sacrament, so you may let them become for us an eternal remedy. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affection, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, and without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Archbishop, Matt, our auxiliary, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. And with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, you may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, is there to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who say to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. O God, who never cease to nourish us by your sacrament, grant that the refreshment you give us through it may bring us unending life through Christ our Lord. Thank you. Have a lovely day. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us go in peace, glorifying God by our lives.